Toastmaster, fellow Toastmasters, and welcome guests. My name, spelled Y-U-S-U-P-H-A, is a good conversation starter. I'm often asked to spell, to either spell it, or I'll find myself responding to anything that sounds closer to it. So I always speak and be known. I was raised in a Wolof household in Serekuna, the largest urban town in the Gambia. Wolof is one of the most prominent ethnic groups, and they are famous for their jollof rice, also called benache. It is the best known dish throughout West Africa. And let me tell you, if you ever happen to visit that region, make sure to try some. It's so delicious. I will never forget making a terrible mistake at the age of 9 during lunchtime one day. I remember digging my left hand into the communal bowl of jollof rice as we all start to eat. My whole family rose in horror and screamed at my mistake, as the left hand is forbidden and considered unclean. I apologize exceedingly, and believe me, that was the last time I made that mistake. It's not easy being a child during communal eating. You've got to wash your hands, hold the bowl, wait for the elders to start eating first, and the list can go on and on. I learned my lesson, however. After I finished high school, I worked for the customs department. My responsibility at that time was the physical examination of freight at the port authority. I really enjoyed my job, but unfortunately, I had to leave Gambia because of a military coup d'etat. I landed in New York City 20 years ago, full of hopes and dreams. So many things were new to me. I had never seen roads so big and tall buildings the size of my entire town. Instead of spending more than 2 hours eating around the communal bowl, I'd have a to-go box and finish it in 30 minutes. Life was moving faster than I thought. I guess I was experiencing culture shock. I was getting a little bit impatient when I received a phone call from my cousin in Seattle. I kept him on the phone for more than an hour. He was a soldier to cry on. He agreed to help me if I could get myself to Seattle. Now, little did I know that coming to Seattle will become an adventure on its own. I know the look from your faces, you are thinking, how did you get here? The answer is, I don't know. I am still lost. I speak for another time. I am married to Ule, the most tolerant woman I've ever met. She's always supportive and inspirational. I am a proud father of two amazing boys, Omar and Keba, and my beautiful daughter, Awa. My greatest achievement is taking care of my family. I became a caregiver shortly after I moved to Seattle. I feel trustworthy and compassionate every day I go to work, knowing that someone is depending on me to deliver the best possible care. The expression of love and appreciation I receive from these patients means a lot to me. The interactions I have with their family members gives me a better understanding of American values and lifestyle. I learned that compassion is a major value for many Americans. I frequently spend many hours commuting these days, which got me in the habit of listening to self-help audio books. It definitely eases my frustration in Seattle's traffic nowadays. And it has a big impact in my life. The great advice and valuable insights I received from these audios feeds my desire to speak. I felt the need to improve my English that I heard about Toastmasters. It seems to be a great place to learn and meet such a wonderful people. Because a man's life lies under his tongue, I am speaking to be known, Madame Toastmasters. Thank you.